Hi guys, and welcome to a new makeup transformation that may be about magic wands and inspired by witches and warlocks and everything magical and creepy. Today I thought I would do my own take on a witch that may include a large nose, chin, a cauldron burn with boils on half of her face, like it just toppled on top of her and she had a terrible accident with spiders crawling on top of that. And yes, I hate spiders too, but let's see if we could do this. And if you notice, my outfit is totally different and really cool. It is a witch's costume from Party City. Favorite costume of mine. It is so comfortable and it's a little bit on the sexy side because it's kind of, you know, hugs you in the right places without being super revealing. It has a slit on the side. It is so cute. These are my own leggings, but it comes with like these little eye figures to it. And I love the hat with like the spikes on the top. And it's purple, which is one of my favorite colors. It has this black netting over it. I just love it. But to start out on the makeup, as you could tell, I have my hair already up in a ponytail. Now to do the structures of the nose and the chin, I would prefer that you get your own nose and chin prosthetics. The Wuchi ones that you get in most Halloween stores aren't the greatest, so I built my own out of mortician's wax. And I'm going to lay down some spear gum. This is RCMA's matte adhesive. Too expensive, so just use plain old spirit gum. I just had this one on hand. You're gonna let that get tacky before you apply the mortician's wax nose and then smooth down the edges of that. And as you can tell, the edges of this aren't completely smoothed down because we are going to use a different kind of wax. This is Ben Nye's Nose and Scar Wax as a transition wax. That means mortician's wax isn't soft enough. Just around the edges, I'm doing it in these like tube-like forms and then smoothing it down. Now once that nose is laid, we're gonna do the chin. So take your adhesive, put it on your chin in a very large area so that it could get tacky, so you have areas to smooth down your wax. And once that adhesive is tacky, we're gonna put the chin piece on that I made out of the mortician's firm wax, and then repeat the steps that you did with the nose, with the Ben Nye Nose and Scar Wax as a transition wax into your skin. Again, I would highly suggest that you buy your own nose and chin prosthetics, or you could even skip this step entirely and just do a witch makeup, because these do not stay on there long. Make sure you get your edges on these as clean as possible. I know it's really hard to form with scar wax. Like I said, you need to get prosthetics if you're gonna do this. But this is what I had on hand, and it's really, really expensive to buy professional grade foam prosthetics. Now we're gonna use Krylon's flexible sealer to seal down this wax so that we could paint on top of it. Remember, when you use sealer, you wanna use something disposable. That's why I'm using a sponge, or you wanna use a Q-tip, because this will destroy your brushes. Unless it's a disposable brush that you don't want anymore. Like maybe it's not your MAC brush, and maybe it's not your fancy painter brush. And I skipped this step, but you should totally do it if you have the time. Get some Duo eyelash glue or some latex and do a stippling motion on top of the wax piece. It will have more of a natural texture than just flat, shiny wax and then your skin. I hope that makes sense because, girl, I skipped that step and now I regret it. On camera, it looks good, but in person, you're like, wait, what? Wait for that to get dry. And then to do a scar effect on half of our face, we are gonna take the RCMA adhesive or spirit gum and do it on a section on half of your face where you want the burn outline to be. Cause girl, she just had a cauldron topple on top of her and it burnt her face up. Now once that side of the burns is tacky enough, you're gonna lay rolls, like Tootsie Rolls of nose and scar wax. And as you're going with the other finger, you're gonna smooth it onto your skin. We're gonna make like a barrier where the skin's gonna be lifting and there's gonna be burn marks in the center. And all the way around that spirit gum pattern that we did on that side of the face. Now once that wax is laid down on there, we are gonna put some more sealer on top. Let that sealer completely dry. You might want to sit around for maybe 30 minutes or so, play some video games or watch one of your favorite TV shows. Now once that sealer is completely dry, we're going to take our favorite foundation in our shade. Mine is Revlon Colorstay. I absolutely love this foundation. And I'm going to add some green paint to it, whatever Halloween green, like we did before in the last makeup transformation. Girl, if you saw the Freddy Krueger one. But we're going to do the same process here and stipple that all on her face, but not inside of that wax piece on half of her face. You know the barrier where the burn mark's going to be? Don't do it inside of there. That's a no-no. I'll show you later. Just make sure to do patting motions so that you don't lift anything off of your face that you don't want to, like those wax pieces. Now we're gonna wait till this foundation layer dries because I didn't and now I regret it, because we are gonna do a taupe color on the mix of this Death Wheel palette. It's a maroon and a gray, so that we could get a taupe colored pigment of cream makeup. And we're gonna do the frown lines. Mainly those frown lines on your smile lines before we move on to the highlights. You want to get whatever lightest foundation that's lighter than the one you have and start patting in the areas where you want pockets of sagging skin. Under your eyes, on your cheeks, and your forehead. If you want a new, updated aging makeup tutorial in at least two different ways that I could show you, please give this video a thumbs up and let me know in the comments. But after you do the highlights, we're gonna go back to that taupe color that we did on our smile frown lines and do it near those highlights that we did before. Now I'm just taking this yellow burnt umber like honey alcoholic paint color with a orange stipple sponge, stippling that all over my face over those old age marks that we did so it makes it look more natural, and we're gonna do layers. If you don't have these alcoholic paints, cream makeups very lightly will work as well. You could do some browns and certain other colors in there as well, and then go over that again with more of those contour color lines of the taupe. Now getting some brown alcoholic paints, I'm just accentuating the contour lines that we did in certain areas. You can fill in your warts if you want, or make more on your face at this point. Moving down to my neck and doing the deep contours of my chest bones to make it look more sunken in a little bit older. Cream makeups would work really good in this step, and more areas on contour on my face. And then we are gonna get the red of the alcoholic paint. If you have alcoholic paints, this is the best way to use it. We're gonna do irritation of the burn mark around our face. Around that wax piece, you're gonna do red stippling, and on your nose and chin as well. You just want it to look irritated and red around the wound mark. Again, I could do a whole video on just burn marks and make it look really cool with a more natural skin color. Now we're gonna get some red cream paint, whichever Halloween one you have, and paint in that wound mark. Once that wound mark is painted in, we're gonna put some vampire or any fake blood. If you know your old age bloods, that would be a lot better than this. It's a lot thicker and easier to work with than this thin vampire blood that you get from the Halloween store. But I understand that this vampire blood is very cheap and easy to get access of. That's why I used it in this tutorial as well. Then I'm just taking some darker blacks and reds and doing it on the edges of that bloody opening in our face. And then more blood on top of that to make it more juicy and delicious. If wounds could be delicious. I don't know, I just talk about wounds like they're succulent pieces of meat. That sounds weird. And now that that opening is all juicy and good, we are going to lay down some boil marks. If you have gelatin, it will probably look a lot more better and natural if you're doing this for our costume party. But I'm gonna use wax pieces and stick them like dots of candy in different shapes with spirit gum all over that wound. It kind of looks like we have a gash on top of an infection. And now I'm just taking the yellow from my Death Wheel palette and tapping that on top of those boil marks, because you want them very yellow, infected, and gross, like they're boils about to pop on your face. Stipple some more red on and around those boil marks, but without deleting all the yellow pigment that we just put on it. Now I'm getting one of my favorite special tricks for third degree burn marks, which is cornflakes. No, these have not gone bad. They have been painted black to look like flaked dead skin. Just slap some spirit gum on the back of it and put that on your face, inside the juicy redness of that wound. It's perfect when you stick it on there and it crunches under your finger. Creepy, I know. Taking some of that red and black paint and doing some irritation on the other eye and some shadowing, because you don't want this giant red gash on your face and like almost completely blank side on the other eye. If you wanted to have a black and blue mark on her eye, that would be very cool, like she got in a super bad accident, witch. Now just getting a brown type of muddy yellow sick color and doing some details of contour around the wound, chin, and face. Now I'm just getting a black paint and I'm gonna start doing more details of blood inside that wound so it looks nice and juicy. Now I'm just getting a black paint and I'm gonna start doing spiders on my face. This is so, so hard. I wish I had more artistic skill to paint intricate little spiders on my face. Maybe I need to practice doing spiders. I think I'm also afraid of it because I'm definitely afraid of spiders. That's why they weren't as good as I wish they'd be. If you want them crawling out of pockets out of your face, that's cool and amazing. I did it on the side of my face, on my forehead. My forehead one's my favorite one. I think because it's easier for me to see and do and I have nicer surface to paint it on. Then over my chin, try to do it as best as you can. I know it's super hard to do spiders on your face if it's hard for me. I can't imagine how hard it is for some of you. Doing a split, like, bloody lip, too. Now that our makeup's done, we're not done yet, we are gonna do some teeth little tricks. Of course, first you're gonna dry your teeth off with a tissue. Get my tooth palette from Pegworks, a mixture of the green and the yellowy brown color, and putting that all over my teeth. And then put some black, like a blacked out tooth, and you can put little bits of black on your gums. And now that we have this absolutely disgusting smile that reminds me of a pirate, it's time to put on the rest of our costume, which is this hat. And I put this eyepiece that came with the costume on top of my head on the hat instead of around my waist where it shows on the costume because I just think it looks cooler, like I'm collecting eyeballs and putting on top of my head. And then this other eye, which you could put between your fingers. And now to top this look off and make it look even more creepy, I'm going to get a white out contact. This is one of those mesh white contacts in that eyeball where the burn mark is. But that is our finished makeup look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll put the links down below to the contact I put in my eye and every other product I use in this video, especially the ones from Party City. I absolutely love their stuff. Taking this off was a challenge only because all the layers of sealers and wax and alcohol paints. What I found to be useful is isopropyl myristate. Just don't get that in your eye, and it's a very confusing word, but it's great if you could find it in professional makeup places. What also works is Ben Nye's Remove It All, and it's easier to get. You can find it on the internet. You need some baby wipes on hand, other makeup remover wipes. Sonia Kashuk's remover is one of my favorites for around the eyes and sensitive areas. Some cotton pads and just all the works. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and had as much fun as I did. Hope you guys have a great and safe Halloween. Thank you so much for watching these videos. I'm going to be celebrating Halloween year-round as always with more makeup videos to come. I cannot wait. Thank you guys so much for the support as always. I'll put the link down below to the Latin Times that I got in next to Michelle Phan. I was on the same list as her and other great YouTubers for my Sugar Skull makeup look. And I just cannot believe that the year is almost over with and we have so many great things that happen and so many great things ahead. Honestly, any and all the things that are happening in my life right now is from you guys. And I'm so grateful and appreciative. I cannot tell you enough from the bottom of my heart. And I'll see you later. Bye.